Hey guys, welcome to my channel Flavors of My World. Today I'll be bringing you a recipe of soft fluffy donuts, and the best part, they do not have any yeast or eggs. So to know how to make these, make sure to watch this video till the end. First of all, we will take 2.5 cups maida or all-purpose flour. The cup I am using here is of 200 ml measurement. To this we will add 1/2 teaspoon baking soda, that is khane wala meetha soda, 1/2 teaspoon baking powder, 1/4 teaspoon salt, and 1/4 cup powdered sugar. Mix it well with the help of a spoon or a spatula or a whisker and make a well. After we make a well, we will add 1/2 cup milk. Make sure to use full fat milk, which should be at room temperature. To this, add 2 teaspoon vinegar. You can also use lime juice, lemon juice if you like. Mix both well so that the vinegar starts reacting to the milk. After that, we will knead it till it forms a dough for about 5 minutes. You may require to add some water. Here I have added 2 tablespoons of water to my dough. Make sure to add the water 1 tablespoon at a time so that you don't make your dough extra wet. Knead it properly for 5 minutes minimum till you have a very clean dough in your hands. Make sure to follow the hand movements that I am doing here, that is stretch the dough and then bring it back. After that, add 2 tablespoon unsalted butter. The butter should be at room temperature. Incorporate the butter to the dough and knead it for about another 5 minutes. After you are done kneading the dough, you will find a very soft fluffy dough. We will then store this dough for about an hour. Make sure to cover the dough with a damp cloth so that it doesn't harden or form any kind of crust or dry out. One thing you need to make sure while you're kneading the dough, that at the starting when you're adding the liquid to the dough, your dough will be a little wet, but do not panic. Once you knead it for 10 minutes, it will form a soft, nice dough and your hands will be completely clean. After an hour, take out the dough and divide it into 3 equal parts. By dividing it into equal parts, it will be very easy to handle it. Make a ball of the dough, dust your counter with some maida or all. Roll it out slightly thick. Now we will need to cut out the donuts. For that, either you can get yourself a donut cutter, which is very easily available in the online market, or you can use cookie cutter of 2 sizes, one for the outer circle and one for the inner circle, or you can use a lid like I'm using over here. You will get an average of 3 donuts from every roll that you do. The extra dough that is left, you can always bring it together and make another donut, but do not work out the dough too much, because as much as you work out the dough, you will get stodgy donuts. Now for the center cutting, I have used a small nozzle. After that, we will be frying these in hot oil, but keep your flame at medium, because if you fry it continuously at high temperature, the outer cover of the donuts will be nice and golden, but inside it will be raw. So fry it at medium temperature so that it is cooked all from the inside. Now, from the leftover donuts, I have cut out these small mini donuts, which will look so cute when they are fried and ready to eat. Your kids will love these, so make sure to do this. I have used a nozzle of a little bigger size to cut out these. Look at them, they are so nice and fluffy. If you want, you can even fill them with the custard filling. Now, we will be melting some chocolate and cinnamon. But I love chocolate donuts, so I'll be using both dark chocolate and white chocolate for these. You can even use milk chocolate if you want. Now, melt this chocolate over double boiler or microwave it for 30 seconds to 60 seconds. Dip your donuts from one side into the chocolate Let the rest over or the extra chocolate fall over in the bowl and then cover it with sprinkles. You can even cover it with chocolate chips or Oreo biscuits or any cookie of your choice. Now I have melted the dark chocolate. I'll be doing this, repeating the same process with dark chocolate also. Here you can cover these with white chocolate, that is, you can just swirl around white chocolate, and within 5 minutes the chocolate will be set and your donuts will be ready to eat.